Hi! In this Excel tutorial, we'll go over how to make a pivot table timeline in Excel. Pivot table timelines are filters that work something like sliders. They can be styled and, because of the slider element, are a great way to make filtering dates in dashboards more interactive and visually appealing. And by the way, if you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. On my screen is sales data that we've created a pivot table and a pivot chart from. The pivot chart is on this other tab along with slicers. This is the same data that we used in our tutorial on Excel slicers, which if you haven't already, make sure you take a moment to watch that too. So I'm going to show you how to insert a pivot table timeline using the same data. So to insert a timeline, place your cursor anywhere in your active pivot table. Then in your pivot table tools, come to the Analyze tab and in the Filter section, select Insert Timeline. And we got an error. So the reason our pivot table timeline won't work is because of how our date is formatted. As this says, it does not have a field formatted as date. Click OK. The reason is the year field isn't really a date field. It looks like it, but it's really just a four-digit number. So for the timeline to work, these date fields need to contain dates that Excel will recognize. I'm going to change these to be January, February, and March of 2016 and 2017 for each associate. So now that I've reformatted our dates, let's change this heading to dates. We'll refresh our data and come back to the Analyze tab, click Insert Timeline, and now we have the option to insert our dates. So now that we've inserted our pivot table timeline, watch how easy it is to filter with it. So first, select how to show the dates. Click here and you can select by years, quarters, month, or days. So then you can slide this bar to one or the other end of your timeline, or you can drag your timeline to make it longer and have less sliding to do. And then to filter for the dates that you want, simply click on the date that you'd like to see and notice how this filters our pivot table, or you can drag and extend this to include an entire range or shrink it again to change that range. And using the timeline tools options, we can change the caption used on the timeline, which pivot table it's connected to if there were multiples, the color that our timeline is using, its size, or if we want to display any of these elements. And using cut and paste, let's move it to where our slicers and pivot chart are. And let's make this a little bit smaller. And filter by years. And notice how the pivot chart is also affected as we filter the date using the timeline. So using a pivot table timeline in combination with slicers can make it super easy to make an interactive dashboard from a pivot table. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create a pivot table timeline in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks!